So, we will try to draw this again. We start as usual from Galgalta.
Tabor de Galgalta.
Taboo of Galgalta. Ab.
Sag.
Sag.
Nekudot de Sag.
The Nekudot of Sag. The descent of the Nekudot of Sag. Downward. All of these Nekudot, they go down. The influence of the Bet. On Nehi of Ak, receiving the Dalet from Nehi of Ak and the Parsa. Sorry.
Rishimot mi Parsa olim.
Rishimot from the Parsa go back up. The Pe of Rosh of Sag. Instead of going down to the Chazeh, as usual, they go up to Nikve Naim of Rosh of Sag. Zivug occurs in Nikve Naim of Rosh of Sag.
And
the Katnut, the smallness of the Olam HaNikudim, goes down, which is Keter.
Keter, Abba ve'ima, ve'zon.
Keter, Abba ve'ima, and Zon. Here we have the Parsa. From the ascent of Pchina Dalet, we have Tzimtzum Bet, the second restriction. Galgalta is Dalet over Dalet, Ab is Dalet over Gimel. Sag is Gimel over Bet. Nekudot of Sag are Bet over Bet. Until when we reach here, it's Bet over Aleph. When we rise here, we have Bet over Aleph, Tzimtzum Bet, under the second restriction. And this is the Katnut of Olam HaNikudim Keter, Abba Vima and Zon, all in Galgalta and Nine. The Achaps are inside. As we say, Achoraim Boito, the posterior is in the home or inside. Then emerges a second Partsuf from the Pe of Rosh of Sag, which is the world of Nikudim in Gadlut, in greatness. Over the Reshimot Dalet over Gimel.
Ten
Sfirot of Keter, 10 Sfirot of Abba Ve'ima, and 10 Sfirot of Zon. It is all 10 Sfirot. 10 Sfirot, 10 Sfirot will do it here. 10 Sfirot. And here there is the breaking, the shattering of Zon. The breaking of Zon and the cancellation or revocation of the Achoraim, the posterior. So everything that caused the Gadlut in the Rosh is cancelled and the Guf itself breaks. This is what we learned. Following that, Reshimo comes out. I think he's going to talk about it, but I'll draw it so we will have it. From the shattering, the Reshimot go back up. And those Reshimot reach, as usual, the pe of osh of sag. Here is the pe. Here it was the nikvei enaim. Then from the pe, the reshimot. Well, instead of bet over aleph, tzimtzum bet, we now have aleph over shorish, tzimtzum bet, because they were purified through the shattering. So accordingly, they rise to the metzach, forehead of Rosh of Sag. This is what the oviyut of shorish is called, metzach. And the zivug takes place in the metzach of Rosh of Sag. And from here, we will learn how the world of Atzilut is born. And it also has Keter, Abba ve'ima, and Zon. However, they're called by different names. But really, it is the same Parzuf of Nikudim, however, on a lower degree. And it is called the Parzuf of Atzilut. So if this is Nikudim, Katnut, and then Gadlut, here we have Atzilut. What else? Actually, we didn't hear anything besides that, right? Can hear you? Oh, yes. Yesut.
We read about it.
We read about Yesut that at the time that the world of Nikudim of Gadlut expanded, we have the Rosh of Abba Ve'ima and a Guf, which is called Dachgat. Then there is another Rosh called Yesut and a Guf called Tanhim. That's inside. In the Gadlut, I didn't put it in there so that I don't overload the drawing. Okay, Abba Ve'ima, here, I'll write that there's also Yeshut here. It includes Yeshut, because Abba Ve'ima is Gar of Bina and Yeshut is Zat of Bina.